VMware has introduced vSphere Distributed Services Engine to offload key ESX services such as NSX. NSX can now run on a DPU, sometimes called a SmartNIC, instead of running on the main processor. DPUs are PCIe cards that have processors and accelerators as well as network interfaces. We want to demonstrate here that installing ESX on a server with a DPU is almost exactly the same as installing it on servers without a DPU. This is true even though the DPU processor runs its own separate instance of ESX. A server without a DPU loads ESXi from one of its boot drives. Once ESXi is running on the processor, the host can run VMs as well as services such as the networking service NSX. Servers have consoles which allow users to interact with ESXi or to configure the host or to load new images of ESXi into boot devices. Servers also have a separate board management computer to manage power, fans, and to run other tasks. BMCs do not run customer applications. Their code is fixed and stable, unlikely to ever change. The BMC will provide a web interface from which users can get a remote virtual console to the main processor. The BMC can provide a virtual boot device to the main processor. To install ESXi, the virtual boot drive uses an ISO with the ESXi installer program that runs as the main processor boots up. The virtual drive also contains an image of ESXi that we want to write into the regular boot device. The three steps to installation are: 1. Perform a boot from the virtual boot drive and run the ESXi installer. 2. Have the installer write the ESXi image into the regular boot device. 3. Boot the host a second time. This time, booting and running ESXi from the regular boot device. On a server with a DPU, the procedure will be the same. Now we have a DPU card with a processor of its own. In our case, it's an ARM processor. The DPU will also run a version of ESX for DPUs. The DPU has a boot device where we need to write the DPU ESXi image. For servers with DPUs, the ISO image on the virtual boot drive still contains the installer and an ESXi image, but now contains a DPU ESXi image as well. VMware has worked hard to make the installation the same as before. There are still three steps. 1. Boot and run the ESXi installer. 2. Have the installer write the ESXi image into the regular boot device and simultaneously write the DPU ESXi image into its boot device. 3. Boot the host a second time. This time, booting and running ESX from the regular boot device and simultaneously booting and running ESX on the DPU. To you, the operator, the only difference is one additional checkbox. You must indicate that ESX should be installed in both places. The first thing you must do is get a copy of the installation disk with the installer and the two ESX images. We'll do this at high speed, since internet downloads are familiar to all. Log in to Customer Connect. Navigate to All Products. Find vSphere and view its download components. Confirm the version and go to the Hypervisor ESXi Downloads. Find and download the ISO image. Accept the agreement. Wait for the download to complete and find the directory with your copy. We can now install ESX on a server with a DPU. This will prepare us to run vSphere Distributed Services Engine. The board management computer on a Dell server is called IDRAC. When your IT department racks up the server, they should assign it an IP address and login credentialing. With a web browser, log into the server. Click on the lower right of the dashboard to bring up the virtual console of the server's main processor. The virtual console has various controls along the top at the right. We will use them to create the virtual boot drive and to boot the server. Click on the virtual media button. Click on Connect Virtual Media. Click Choose File and navigate to the ESX installation ISO image we just downloaded and click Open. Click Map Device and then close the dialog. Click on the Boot button. Note that this is to configure the boot, not to power on the server. Choose the Virtual CD DVD ISO option and confirm with the Yes button. Now click the Power button and then the Power On System option. Some time-lapse magic will get us through the boot process quickly. Observe that on this first boot, we are not booting up ESXi. We are booting up the ESXi installer. We need to confirm that we want to install ESXi. We'll bring up the virtual keyboard to make this and our next entries more visible. Click on the keyboard button, then hit Enter. Now hit the F11 button to accept the end user license agreement. Wonder briefly if you should have gone into law, but then proceed with something productive. We are now at the single place where you do something different than a standard installation. Use the arrow keys and spacebar to select both checkboxes, the one for ESXi on the main processor and the one for ESXi on the DPU, then hit Enter. Next, use the spacebar to select the boot device for ESXi on the main processor. On the Dell machine in our example, this will be the Dell Boss Virtual Disk. You do not make a choice for the DPU boot device. Hit Enter to continue. Choose your installation option. We are choosing a completely new installation, overriding previous installs and file systems. Press Enter to continue. Choose your keyboard language. Create a root password. This is to log in as root on either instance of ESXi. Hit Enter to continue. Confirm you are installing ESX on both the server and the DPU with the F11 button. We now fast forward through the writing of the two images. Now you hit Enter to reboot for the second time. After this reboot, we will be running ESX on the main processor and on the DPU. Again, a little bit of time-lapse video speeds us through the boot. We are now looking at the splash screen of ESXi running on the main processor. What remains to do is configure ESXi with networking information and troubleshooting options. This is the same as you would do for any server. You do not make any configuration choices for the DPU. ESXi makes all those choices for you. The two ESX instances communicate and coordinate behind the scenes. You only have to work with the server as you normally would. Direct access to the DPU is possible, but is rarely necessary. We hit F2 and log in as root to begin the configuration. Since this is the standard procedure, we'll move through this quickly. Configure the management network. The network adapter is typically VMNIC0. Set the VLAN. Configure the IPv4 address mask and other values. Set the IPv6 configuration if necessary. Configure the DNS settings. Set the DNS suffix. If you need, you can enable the ESXi shell, SSH, and other troubleshooting options. Be aware of any attack surfaces these may create. Now, ESXi has a web interface of its own, so as a last step, let's log in to that to verify that our installation was successful. Browse to the IP address you just configured and log in as root. Here we see the ESXi host client page. All seems well. And there you have it. Installing ESX on the server with the DPU is not twice the work as a server without. It is exactly the same, except for that one extra checkbox for the DPU. Thank you.